This may be one of the most common conditions that gets people taken out of wearing contact lenses. Let's focus in. Giant papillary conjunctivitis, or GPC. It's a mouthful. In this video, we're going over what it is, symptoms, causes, and three tips that you could do to hopefully prevent you from getting GPC. GPC is the swelling of the inner eyelid, and it mainly happens on the top eyelids, and they'll become inflamed and develop these round bumps called papillae. Now, people can normally develop papillary conjunctivitis, maybe from allergies or bacterial infections, or they'll develop small versions of these papillae, but when you have large round bumps, large round papillae that are 1 millimeter in diameter or larger, this is giant papillary conjunctivitis. Now, people can get a primary GPC from chronic allergies, but most commonly, people can get a secondary GPC from wearing contact lenses. Now, in general, GPC can come from any chronic rubbing or irritation of a foreign body in the eye. It will chronically rub on the inner eyelid. And this can be from stitches or sutures from an eye surgery, prosthetic eyes that people wear, and most commonly from contact lenses. And it could be from developing an allergy to the contact lens itself, but most commonly it can be from the chronic irritation of the deposits that get on the contact lens. We'll get protein deposits that cake onto the surface of the lens, creating a biofilm, and when the eyelids constantly rub over that protein, that biofilm, it will cause that allergic reaction. It'll cause the giant papillae to show up. It can also show up from the cleaning solutions that you're using on the contact lenses or the contact lens itself. If it's poorly fit and rubbing and poking weird, then sometimes that can cause GPC as well. Now, the symptoms of GPC are usually redness, irritation, pain. Your eyes will feel itchy a lot. You'll want to rub them like this a lot. It can also cause a mucus buildup and cause blurry vision. And you may also notice that your contact lenses start moving weird. So when you blink, if you have those bumps, sometimes those bumps will actually grab a hold of the contact and pick it up and then drop it down so it feels like your contact is moving and shuffling more than it used to. One thing that people might notice is sometimes when they take their contact lens out, they might feel the symptoms a little bit more. They might feel the irritation more because the contact lens isn't there to shield the eye from the eyelid. So when the contact's gone, sometimes the eyeball will actually feel those bumps a little bit more moving around. Might feel like something's poking or scratching the eye. Might feel like there's a hair in there. But yeah, it can be kind of weird when you take the contact lens out. So what type of treatment is there for GPC? Now, if you're a contact lens wearer and you go into your eye doctor, a lot of times your eye doctor will actually check underneath your eyelid. They'll actually flip the eyelid up. Kind of weird, but we'll use a Q-tip and actually flip the eyelid up so we can see underneath the eyelid and check for those bumps. It doesn't hurt. It just feels weird, kind of uncomfortable. Now, usually when we see GPC, there are a few treatments that we can do. Number one, depending on the severity, we usually take you out of the contact lenses to give the eyelid a break from that chronic irritation. You can also be prescribed anti-allergy or anti-inflammatory eye drops to get rid of those bumps. Now, what stinks is it could take 2 to 4 weeks, sometimes months, to get rid of GPC. Now, when it's resolved, your eye doctor may recommend switching to daily contact lenses to reduce the chance of that chronic irritation or the buildup of the biofilm on the contacts, because you'll start with a new contact lens every day. And dailies are usually thinner, so you won't have as much of irritation on the eyelid. Now, sometimes GPC can be stubborn to get rid of, and there are patients that end up not being able to wear contact lenses. They end up having to switch over to glasses full time, or maybe they start looking into LASIK. Now, chances are if you're watching this video, your eye doctor probably mentioned something about GPC to you, or you've had it in the past. If so, definitely leave a comment below. I'm kind of curious to hear your experience, what helped you get rid of GPC, what you did to treat yours and get rid of yours, or if you just had to get taken out of contact lenses altogether. Now, let me give you three tips that may help prevent you from getting GPC in the future. Number one, since it's mainly going to be related to your contact lenses, and that's to reduce your contact lens wear time. Now, most of the time, GP happens with people that tend to overwear their contact lenses. If they're in a 2 week or a monthly contact lens, they tend to wear them longer than they should. And so if you can reduce that time to when you're supposed to take them out and replace them with a fresh pair, this will be best for your eyes. Now, if you're one that tends to sleep in or nap in your contact lenses, you're gonna wanna cut that out. People that have had GPC or mild GPC, They usually never sleep in their contact lenses. Even if the contact lenses are approved for sleeping in them, you just want to cut that out, reduce the wear time or the contact to that eyelid. Also, for someone that wears their contacts many hours during the day, if you're wearing them for 20 hours, you only sleep 4 hours a night, you will want to try to reduce the wear time, get those hours down. The more you're out of the contact lenses, the less likely you'll develop GPC. Tip number two, and that's to clean your contact lenses with a type of hydrogen peroxide preservative-free contact lens solution like Clear Care. This can hopefully remove any biofilm or protein deposits that are on the surface of the contact lens, so lessening the chance of getting GPC, lessening the exposure to that inner eyelid. Number three, and that's to use an anti-allergy eye drop. If you're somebody that already has eye allergies, even if they're really mild, you may want to look into getting an allergy eye drop like Pataday or Aloe. Even if you're just using it once a day, maybe in the morning, 10 minutes before you put your contact lenses in, this may help or lessen the chances of developing these large papillae, the giant papillary conjunctivitis. Now, if you want to learn more in depth about contact lenses, cleaning your contact lenses correctly, definitely check out my playlist right here or one of my other videos right here to learn more about the eyes. I'm Dr. Neil Guyman, Dr. Eye Guy. Stay focused.